morning, everybody. Nick DiVirgilio here. I'm at the Sabian Factory in Maductic, New Brunswick, Canada. And we're gonna go through the factory, take the tour, and we're gonna watch them building the cymbals I'm gonna use on the Car Over High and Blues project. Let's go. I'm here with Mark Love, cymbal guru here at Sabian. Been here many years. You know the ins and outs of all the cymbals here. We're standing now in the vault. Now, I know this is a kind of a historic place. I've heard about the vault. How many cymbals are in here at any given time?
Now, we probably have about 60,000 cymbals. That's all the different series together, but it was over double that at one time.
Roughly, how many cymbals do you guys make a day?
It varies anywhere from 10,000 to 20,000 a week.
A lot of people wanting to make music.
Yeah, and that's great.
We'll be back with Mark in a second, but first we're going to cross the busy main street that cuts the Sabian factory in half.
All right, this is the first step in the process of cymbal making. It's a really cool process. I'm here with Chris. He's been doing this job for quite a long time. 15 years you've been doing this particular job, correct? And tell us what you have in your hand right here.
This here would be the casting mold. This is the first step to the finished product that you're looking for. If you look behind us, this is the rolling oven. It runs at about 1380 degrees. And this casting, the first time, we get put in there for about 45 minutes. And then once it's heated up and it becomes bright orange, we'll begin to put them through the rolling mill that you see behind us. And they get thinner and thinner, and then we begin to mic them so we can get them at the exact thickness that you're looking for.
Right. And every cymbal has its own thickness and diameter, right?
Yes.
Depending on what it's going to be in the end process.
Yes.
Not every cymbal comes from the same size ingot, right? You have
Correct.
The foundry in the back where you melt the metal.
Yes.
And then you melt those into different sizes?
Depending on the size of the cymbal and the thickness you want, this size casting will vary. We could be up to 16 to 18 pounds, and we've been as small as 2 pounds.
So say you're going to make a 16-inch crash.
Yes.
How big is the blank that you want to get out of the oven?
Probably around roughly 18 inches, because you still got to have room to circle it down when you're done.
Okay. Now, we were over across the street, and we saw the blanks being made. Now we're over here. Can you explain what's going on at this side?
Once the cymbals come to this side of the road, the first step is actually the cupping. So what we'll do is we'll put them in the large ovens, same ovens that we do the rolling in. We heat them up red hot, and then we pass them through a cupping machine that actually presses the bell in one at a time, and they let them cool, and then they move on to the tempering or annealing process. And that process is to actually soften the metal. Before they temper them, the cymbals are actually like glass. You could actually break them up with your hands, or if you throw them on the floor, they would just shatter. They'll put maybe 10 cymbals at a time in the tempering oven. They heat them up to the red hot 1340 degrees, and then they quench them. They have to put them in the cold water bath in the big tub in front of the oven. So once they're tempered, they bring them out of the water, and then they drill the center hole, and then they circle them. Whatever diameter, we circle them usually a quarter inch oversize.
After he cut off the edge, and I saw him working the metal up and down and back and forth and turning it and moving it again. What's he doing at that point?
Okay, that's a process we call back bending. You have to work that metal before you press it into shape. It kind of has a memory, it won't hold that.
Okay.
So you have to flex it and bend it and work it. And then when you press it into a relative shape on the die, it'll maintain that shape more even. Now if it's going to be a hand hammer cymbal, we actually even out the profile from the bell out and make it very straight. And then they hammer it up into shape rather than pressing it. So that's the only difference with the hand hammers. After the pressing or bumping, the next step is to go to the lathe and hammer room. And then they would move on to the lathing. And depending on the model, some are lathed only on the bottom. Some aren't lathed at all. Some may have strips of unlathed sections like the Legacy. We do a lot of raw bell cymbals. And then we actually have some models that we hammer, lathe, and then rehammer. Like a Legacy Crash, we hand hammer, lathe, and then HHX hammer.
So as we were watching the guys hammering the cymbals, after a while they'd break out a template and put it on top of the cymbal and check around. Why is that piece so important?
Well, that's really a guide. For each particular model, we have a preferred shape, and they're building that profile, whether it's hand hammering or machine hammering, to that shape. It has to be consistent throughout in order to end up with a consistent sound at the end. And if it doesn't meet our sound requirements, then it's a reject, and we cut it up, and we melt it down, and we start all over again.
Okay. So you can't recycle the metal again and start over?
Oh, absolutely. Everything from reject cymbals to shavings, everything that you see through the process, we recycle all of that.
Next thing is the edging and kind of smoothing out.
Since everything's made a quarter inch oversized, the lathing goes out to the edge, and then the edging just trues everything up, takes any sharp edges off, rounds it, makes it safe to handle and play. And from there, they come into the vault, and every cymbal is tested and scrutinized.
And that's where we are now. I know these are already cool, but let's see what they sound like. I love the darkness of the stick hitting the cymbal. I could tell I could shuffle these when I'm playing a shuffle groove. These will sound really good with that kind of. That is a nice combination. I think it would fit perfectly for the Carl Verheyen project.
I think so too. I think it's great. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot. It's been a fantastic day here at the Sabian Factory. Everybody's been great. It's been wonderful to see how these cymbals are made and go through the whole process. And now I can't wait to get home to Sweetwater, get in the studio, and make some fantastic music with Carl Verheyen and the boys.